Hey everybody, Crystal Gamer here with a new build video for you. So this one is for my fitness stuff challenge, or it's not for the challenge because it's my challenge, so I don't participate in it myself, but I'll often do a build in line with my challenge, and those that follow me regularly will know that anyway. But if you're not familiar with the challenge, if you don't follow on Twitter, I do a challenge every few weeks that is a pack challenge, essentially. It's make me want to buy X pack in one tweet, and so people have four photos to submit the pack. If you're interested, if you're unaware of it and you're interested in potentially participating, this time it's KG Fitness Stuff is the hashtag KG Fitness Stuff. And there's a few more days left to get in entries right now. And yeah, so I usually try to do a build or something in line with my challenge. And so that's what this one is here. And so the current challenge focuses on fitness stuff, which a lot of people I think are doing gyms and health spas for. I don't really look hard at the entries when they come in. I don't like to sort of prejudge or whatever. I like to look at them when I'm actually doing the review. So I haven't really seen them, but I think that the majority are gyms and spas. So I went in a different direction, although the front of this could be the front of a gym or spa, but it's actually an estate. And it's a small estate. It's a 20 by 30 lot, so it's a small place. But I wanted to do something that was more in the realm of a home than a gym or spa because, I don't know, I love the fitness stuff furniture, and the buy items I think are really cool, and actually even the doors and the windows are really cool too. So they're cool for a modern place, and this is obviously a modern build. You kind of can't use those doors and windows without it being a modern build, I don't think. I can't really see them in a rustic thing, so. But yeah, so I wanted to use the fitness stuff furniture because I definitely really like it and I wanted to show it off. And also, I discovered in this procedure that the fitness stuff doesn't have nearly as much fitness stuff as I expected it to have. So that's kind of interesting. It's one thing really good about doing these pack challenges is they sort of force me to learn what's in the packs a little bit more than I do, which is awesome. And I don't know, I had some misconception that there was a ton of fitness stuff in the fitness stuff pack, which is not accurate. There actually isn't very much fitness stuff in the fitness stuff pack at all. There's one workout machine, one weightlifting machine, and then a treadmill, and then of course the rock climbing wall. So, but that's all that there is for fitness stuff. I really thought that there would be more, but that's it. And so obviously this house has all the furniture from the fitness stuff. I think that I use most of everything that's in the pack. Unfortunately, I forgot to use some of the mirrors, and I meant to. I may before I put it up, it has those small square mirrors that are cool, and I could actually use those. I think I have a wall that I could use those on that might look cool, but that's one of the items that I forgot to use. But I think I used, I don't know, 99% of the fitness stuff pack in the build. And so, and there's no CC. Also, if you're interested in downloading, I know CC sometimes a deterrent for people. There's no CC in this build. As much as I would like to put CC in every build, I'm trying to sort of alternate a little bit so that those that really don't like to download with CC, so that I don't have every build having CC, but so I'm alternating a little bit between builds that have it now and builds that don't. And so this one has no CC. It is like 98% fitness stuff or something. And then I think that there's maybe a half a dozen items from other packs. And of course the game's telling me incorrectly, I think. It's doing that thing, the gallery's doing that thing when I uploaded it, that it says that there's like two or three packs being used, but then if you click on it and you ask it, you know, which items of the pack is being used, it says that none are being used. So I don't know, it's listing two or three packs that I don't even think that I used, because there's nothing listed there. And to my knowledge, it uses maybe half a dozen items from other packs. So if you want a pack, if you want to build that's predominantly fitness stuff, I think that this is probably pretty good. And very unusual for me. It came in at a decent amount of money. Like, it's not a $300,000 or $400,000 house. It came in at $100,000 something. And the lower end of $100,000, I can't remember exactly how much, might be like $115,000 or something, which for me is a pretty cheap build. So yay. This is like a budget build in Crystal's world. So, but it's only one bedroom. So that's something to keep in mind. It is a one bedroom. The upstairs sinks, I did this weird thing in the ensuite that goes with the master bedroom where I used a couple of the kitchen counters and I wanted to use the fitness step sinks, but they don't blend very well with kitchen counters. So what I did was I put them in and I lifted them up a couple of notches. So I haven't play tested, but I'm about 99% sure that those two sinks are not going to work in play testing. But I don't know about you guys, I hardly ever use sinks when I actually play the game, so it may not matter to someone at all. For me, the build has two sinks downstairs, one in the kitchen and one in the half bath, so that would be enough for me gameplay-wise, and I would be able to just keep the upstairs ensuite sinks looking kind of cool the way they are without needing to be used. But you know, that's going to be a personal preference thing. If someone wants to download the build and use it, all they have to do is take out those counters and lower those sinks a couple of notches and it's perfect. But yeah, so it's only a one bedroom and it could be made into a two bedroom. It's got kind of this landing area that I do this little fitness area on, of course, because I had to throw in the workout things, the workout machines that came with the fitness pack. That was necessary, I felt, in this build. If it's going to be a fitness pack build, I need to have those couple of machines, not the rock climbing wall, of course, because I didn't want to have super tall walls. This build has the medium height walls as it is, so it's got pretty tall walls as it is, because I think that they lend themselves well to modern builds, and let's face it, you can't use the windows and doors for fitness stuff unless you go up to the medium height walls anyway. So, but I wasn't going to go with the huge walls that you need to get the rock climbing gym. I didn't feel it was necessary to have that in a home build. So I do give them a nice little pool deck area and stuff out back. So it's a pretty nice house, especially for a one bedroom. It's definitely, like I said, it's small. It's a small estate, but for a one bedroom place, it's on the upper end of things, I would say. It's definitely a nice build. These are people that have a little bit of money, even though it's only a one bedroom. It would be a kind of expensive one bedroom probably in the real world. It's got a very, very open floor plan downstairs, so that's a very modern thing. I played with the roof on this for a while too. I started out with this simple slab of a roof and I felt it was too boring even for a modern home. I feel a lot of times that modern home builds have kind of boring roofs a little bit sometimes, not always, but sometimes. But so I don't know, I had this slab of a roof and it was fine and it worked and all that, but I felt it was a little bit boring, and so I wanted to do a little something with it. And so I decided to separate the middle from the two sides, because I have the decks in the back and then on either side, and then in the front I have the deck in the front. So I tried to do something with that, and then it was okay, but it wasn't really working for me. And at the very, very end, and it's not on camera, I don't think it's on camera, at the very end I decide to switch out the roofs on the two sides with the decks in the back, and so I reverse those, so I end up with a roof that it's got three pieces and it's facing in either direction, and it made it just a hair more interesting to me, I felt. So, but I don't think I caught that part on camera. I recorded the bulk of it, and actually, this was a pretty fast build. I tried to do a 3-hour build challenge, and I think that you guys are going to see that after this. I think that I'm going to release this first, and then I'm going to release the other one, and it's actually, that's a small estate as well. And I was trying to do a 3-hour build challenge on that, and I didn't come anywhere close, not at all. I came closer with this to a 3-hour build challenge, but I'm not going to count this. I'm not going to count it towards the 3-hour build challenge. I feel like I need to do another one, but that's sort of tells me something. If I stick predominantly to one pack, it's faster and easier. I'm really limited, right? So it's faster and easier because I'm so limited. I don't have all those choices and everything, and so I don't take as much time. So that may be something for me to consider when I do the 3-hour build challenge a second time, when I try it a second time. And I do have to try it a second time because my first attempt was a miserable failure of not getting anywhere close to 3 hours. This one here, I think I finished the bulk of it in 2 and probably the detailing and stuff in the last hour. So I may have actually done it in 3 hours. I only recorded 2 hours of footage because my end detailing and stuff, I'm turning the camera so much that it would just make people sick watching it. And I didn't do, I didn't do a ton of clutter in this because it's modern. It's kind of minimalist. So there's that. And I've managed to talk my way all the way through to the end, which is pretty amazing. I like the shape on this pool, by the way, the end of it. I ended up changing the shape a little bit, so that became a little bit more interesting. And you can see the funky 3-tier roof thingy in the cinematic as well. So I changed the roof up a little bit to make that a little bit more interesting for sure. And yeah, I guess that's probably about all that I can tell you on this build. I haven't built a family for it. It's just, a single, a couple or a single would be fine here, and that would work because it's just the one bedroom. But yeah, that's about it on this one. And I do hope that if you haven't entered or I haven't looked into the contest, that you do. And thanks so much for spending the time with me today. Make sure that you, make sure you like, subscribe, comment, all that stuff. I'm supposed to say that at the end of every video, every now and then you forget. But yeah, if you're not subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And thanks so much for spending the time with me today. I appreciate it. And I hope to see you all back again next time. Bye now.